Students, welcome in our English online class. Students, today we will do a new chapter of English grammar, and the name of the chapter is Kind of Sentences. Students, before begin this chapter, we will do a short discussion on sentences. What are sentences? So, student, sentence is a group or set of words that is complete and meaningful in itself. Okay, students? So, I will explain the definition with the help of two examples. I have written two sentences, number one and number two. Okay, students? First of all, I am reading the sentence number one. Drives car she a. Drives car she a. Now this sentence, here also as we read in the definition, sentence is a group or set of words. So the first sentence is a group or set of words. Okay, now I'm reading the second one. Second sentence is, she drives a car. Okay, she drives a car. Now second sentence is also a group or set of words. So students, can you tell me out of these two sentences, which one is the correct? The second one, she drives a car, because this sentence gives a complete meaning in itself. That's why this sentence is correct in itself. So sentence is a group or set of words that is complete and meaningful in itself. Now, after this, we will discuss about the types of sentences. So, students, the first one is declarative sentence. Now, what are declarative sentences? Declarative sentence is a statement. Statement sentence, it gives information about someone or something. For example, the children are tired. This sentence gives an information about the children, that what are they doing? They are tired now. So the children are tired. So this is a statement about the children. Now declarative sentences are of two types, positive and negative. When there is positive sense in a sentence, when there is no negation in a sentence, the children are tired. Positive statement, there is no negation in the statement. So, this will be a positive declarative sentence. Now, next one, the children are not tired. So, here when we will add here not, it becomes a negative sentence, means negation. So, this is negative sentence. The children are not tired. So, this one is negative declarative sentence. Okay, students? Now, so in declarative sentences, we have two types, positive and negative. Positive means positive statement and negative means negative statement in which negation will be there, not will be there. Now, next one, second one is interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences means this asks a question. And for asking a question, we will put a question mark at the end of a sentence. By this, we can easily understand that this sentence is of interrogative sentence. For example, where do you live? Okay, we can also make the interrogative sentences with the WH family and with the helping verbs. Suppose, where do you live? This sentence I have made with the WH family. In WH family, we have more words as who, what, where, when, how, which, whose. So, with these words, we can make the interrogative sentences. Now, with the helping verbs, when we will get the answer in yes or no, we can also make the interrogative sentences as, is he going to school? So, when I will ask this question to someone, I will get the answer in yes or no. Yes, he is going to school. No, he is not going to sentences with WH family. Now, and with the helping verbs also. Now, the next one is imperative sentences. Imperative sentences we use to give commands, to order, and to request someone for something. For example, shut the door. When I will speak this sentence, I am giving order to someone. Shut the door, close the door, please come in, please go out. So this type of sentences, come in. I am giving someone to come, order to someone to come in. So this type of sentences tell us about the order in a sentence. So these are imperative sentences. Now student, you will see one thing in this type of sentence, is that this type of sentence begin with a verb. Shut. Shut the door, close the door, come in, go out. So here the first word is verb. So imperative sentences begins with a verb. Now second word, please wait for some time. So here when I will add here please, it means I am requesting to someone. So after this word please, again I have a verb. So this type of sentences, imperative sentences, begin with a verb. So imperative sentences uses to give commands, when I will give command to someone, when I will give order to someone, then I will request to someone for something, that type of sentences will come under imperative sentences. Okay students, now next one is exclamatory sentences. Exclamatory sentences we make with the help of exclamation mark. And what is exclamation mark? This is an exclamation mark. Okay students, so exclamatory sentences we use to express our certain feelings, emotions about something. For example, what a beautiful day it is. Suppose I am too happy today. Today is a special day for me. So I will write what a beautiful day it is. Now next one, hurrah, we won the match. I am too happy because today I won my team and we won the match. So that time I will use this sudden happiness. And after that I will put this exclamation mark to complete my sentence, and this exclamatory sentence. So without this exclamation mark, my sentence is incomplete. It's compulsory to make this mark when we are writing the exclamatory sentences. So this type of sentences which tell us about our certain feelings, certain emotions, that time we use the exclamatory sentences. So students, today we learn about the four types of sentences, that is declarative sentence, interrogative sentence where we put this question mark. Next is imperative sentence, in which we give order, command to someone, or we request also to someone. And this one, that is exclamatory sentence, which tell us about the sudden feelings and emotions of someone, which we make with this exclamation mark. So students, pause the video carefully, read the chapter and try to understand it. That's all for today's lesson. Have a nice day.